Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to a special Tuesday afternoon edition of the Micro-Nissan Cadillac High School Softball Game of the Week. I'm Steve Wilson, coming to you live from the campus of Cocoa High School, where this evening the Cocoa Tigers play host to the Ashland Kittens from Ashland, Kentucky. Head coaches, captains meeting at home plate as we speak, going over the ground rules. We'll grab a quick word with Coach Scott Ingram of the Kittens in just a few minutes. We're probably, I would estimate, 8 to 10 minutes away from the first pitch. The Ashland Kittens on spring breaks this week have made the trek to Florida to play in a tournament. They've played 3 or 4 games already. They're playing the Cocoa Tigers, obviously, tonight. They will be playing the Merritt Island Mustangs tomorrow, so they're going to mix in a couple of local Brevard County teams with the teams from out of the area. We're going to change headsets, run out to the field, have a quick word with Coach Ingram. Once again, we're approximately 7 or 8 minutes away from pitch number one.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Cocoa Tiger Stadium, and a special welcome to our visiting team from Ashland, Kentucky. Tonight's game pits the Kittens from Ashland versus your Cocoa Tigers. First, a lineup for Ashland. Leading off, playing center field, number 2, Gabby Ingram. Batting second, playing shortstop, number 14, Katie Baldup. Batting third, pitching, number 12, Megan Murphy. Batting fourth, playing third base, 51, Haley Kilborn.
By the PA announcer Mike Sullivan, as we speak.
Catching, number 9, Sydney Campbell.
We're going to go with the starting lineup tonight.
Playing first base, number 32.
Beginning first with a visit from Ashland, Kentucky.
Batting 7, first, playing left field, number 21, Olivia McKenzie.
Center fielder number 2, Gabby Ingram. Batting second, where number 14,
eight,
shortstop,
playing
Katie
second
Baldock.
Base, number 23, Caitlin McKenzie.
Batting
McKenzie.
Third for the Kittens and doing the pitching, number 12, Megan Murphy.
Batting ninth, playing right field, number 11,
Ashland,
Megan
third baseman, number 51, Haley Kilburn.
Substitute for Ashland.
Batting fifth,
number 8,
the catcher,
Maddie
number
Green.
Nine. Excuse me,
number
Sydney
1,
Campbell.
Zoe Ingram.
Batting 6 tonight for the Kittens. First
number
baseman,
18,
number 32,
Caitlin Ferguson.
Maddie Schivel.
Number
16,
Michaela Akers.
Number 21, Olivia McKenzie.
Number 22, Sarah Mullen.
Batting 8, second baseman,
number
23,
Abby Stambo.
Caitlin McKenzie. Batting 9 for the Kittens, right fielder.
The Kittens are coached
number
by
11,
Coach Ingram.
Megan Atkins. Non-starters tonight for the Kittens, number 8, Maddie
Green. Now the lineup for your homestanding Cocoa
Ingram.
Tigers.
Number 18, Caitlin Ferguson.
Leading off,
number
playing 16, shortstop.
Michaela
number
Akers.
2, Abby Sullivan.
Sarah Mullins. And number 26,
batting
Abby
second,
Stambaugh.
Playing third, playing first.
The Ashland Kittens.
Number 4, senior Corey Maxner.
Head coach Scott Ingram. Kittens come into tonight's contest.
Batting third, pitching,
with a 9-2
number 19,
record.
Mayanna Robinson.
We'll go over the starting lineup.
Batting fourth, playing left field.
Now for the home team,
number 44,
the Cocoa Tigers.
Senior Alyssa Murphy.
Batting first, playing shortstop, number 2, Abby Sullivan.
Batting fifth, playing
batting
second
second,
base,
first baseman,
01, Chelsea
number
Miller.
Number 4, Corey Maxner. Batting third for the
batting
Tigers,
six,
pitching, number 19,
99,
Robin.
Kayla Anderson.
Batting fourth, left fielder, number 44,
Alyssa
batting Murphy.
Batting 7th, playing third base, number
batting
43,
fifth,
Kira Davis.
Third baseman, number 01, Chelsea Miller.
Batting 8,
batting
playing
six,
center
Cocoa
field,
Tigers,
number 13, senior
player,
Cassidy
number
99,
Metzger. Kayla Anderson.
Batting
7th,
and catching,
second baseman, number
43, number 10, Madison Lawson.
Kira Davis. Batting eighth for the Tigers,
number 16, senior Cassidy Metzger.
Batting ninth for the Tigers, doing the catching, number 10.
Substitutes for the Tigers,
Lawson.
Number 26,
and
Allie
right
Clement.
For the Tigers,
number 5, Reagan Hughes. Number 22, Savannah Pruitt.
Tigers, number 26,
number 8, Mackenzie Hoffman.
Number 5, Reagan
Hughes. The Tigers
Hughes.
Are coached by
number
Mike
22,
Lawson.
Savannah Pruitt. And number
ladies
8,
and gentlemen,
Mackenzie
please
Hoffman.
Stand.
Those are your starters and non-starters.
Remove your hats for the playing of the national anthem.
National anthem. Cocoa High School. I'm Steve Wilson tonight, flying solo. My partner in crime, Orville Susong, once again with the night off. I guess that's okay when you're the boss, you can do that. But we're moments away from pitch number one between the Ashland Kittens and the Cocoa Tigers. We're going to set the defense for the Cocoa Tigers. Out of left field, Alyssa Murphy, center fielder. Cassidy Metzger over in right field. Shyla True around the horn for the Tigers. Third baseman, Chelsea Miller. At shortstop, Abby Sullivan. Second baseman, Kira Davis. Over at first base, Corey Maxner. The battery tonight for the Cocoa Tigers behind home plate, Madison Lawson. And in the circle for the Tigers, number 19, Mianna Robinson. On the campus of Cocoa High School, we are moments away from the first game. A lot of background noise. The best job we can with lighting the students at Cocoa High School. Close to the power. The Ashland Kittens tonight, moments away from stepping into the batter's box. Center field is number 2, Gabby Ingram. On deck, Katie Baldock, and in the hole. For the Kittens, number 12, Megan Murphy. Mianna Robinson giving her a lap in the offseason. Coach Scott Ingram makes his way to the third base box. Once again, the weather could not be nicer for softball game. Nice little breeze blowing across the field from right field to left field. As Gabby Ingram makes her way.
Leading off for Ashland at the top of the first, number 2, Gabby Ingram.
Kittens came up a little short today in their one and only softball game. The level of competition has been pretty steep. This is a team in Ashland that went deep into the playoffs last year. A lot of youngsters back, shifting some positions around. Mianna Robinson ready to throw the first pitch of this game. Well hit ball in the gap between right field and center field will be a she's picking up the coach.
Go
at
third.
Gabby Ingram can lead up this contest with a stand-up double. A well-hit ball on the first pitch by the Kittens center fielder.
Now batting number 14, Katie Baldock.
And that'll bring up shortstop number 14, Katie Baldock. Baldock hitting from the right side. With a runner on second, nobody out, top of the first inning. Baldock takes a quick glance down into the third base box at Coach Scott Ingram. Back in the box, call strike, no balls and one strike. Nice pitch by Mayan Robinson. Infield playing at about normal depth, as is the outfield. Outfield playing straight up. Pitch by Robinson. Just a little outside, evens it up at one ball and one strike. Ingram leads off the top of the first with a double. She's standing on second. Here's the pitch by Robinson. Ground ball to Sullivan at shortstop. She picks it up, fires across the diamond, breaking for third base. Close play, she was safe. Good hustle, good base running by Gabby Ingram. Baldock rounds into a 6-3. But Ingram advances to third on the putout. So now the Kittens have a runner on third, one out, and that'll bring up the pitcher for the Ashland Kittens, number 12, Megan Murphy. Quick timeout call to the base at third base as Gabby Ingram was sliding in, became unhinged, so to speak. So they're doing a little housekeeping at this point in time. We'd like to thank Micah of Mid-Nissan Cadillac. The title sponsor for the Friday Night Locker Room is located on the 520 Causeway Merritt Island. They are an authorized sales and service outlet for new Nissan and Cadillac products, and they carry a line of used cars and trucks. Website, MikeErdmanMotors.com. The telephone,
how about it, number 12, Megan Murphy.
453-2050. Megan Murphy about ready to step into the batter's box. She'll be hitting from the right side as well. First pitch at the knees, call strike, no balls and one strike. Kittens threatening in the top of the first inning, no score. Gabby Ingram 60 feet away from the first run of this ball game. Here's the pitch by Robinson. Just a little inside, evens it up at 1-1. One ball, one strike. Line drive, base hit by Murphy. Ingram will walk home. Murphy's going to stop at first base. A well-hit ball to left field. Nice job by the left fielder, Alyssa Murphy, getting the ball in a hurry. So Megan Murphy picks up the first RBI of this game as Gabby Ingram crosses home plate.
Now batting number 51, Haley Kilburn.
That'll bring up the third baseman for the Kittens, number 51, Haley Kilburn. We're going to have Maddie Green running for the pitcher, Megan Murphy. So Green will now be running at first base for the Ashland Kittens. Kilburn hitting from the right side. Pitch by Robinson. Just a little low. One ball and no strikes. Ashland Kittens hit pay dirt first in the top of the first inning. It's 1-0 Ashland with a runner on first and one out. Pitch by Robinson. Off speed pitch high and away. Two balls and no strikes. Good crowd tonight. On the home side, the Cocoa Tigers side, it is senior night, and a really nice crowd has come down to Florida from Ashland, Kentucky. Wind up in the pitch, ground ball foul made. Coach Scott Ingram do a little dance down in the third base box. Good job, Coach. Two balls and one strike. Kilburn got around on that one just a little bit too much. She'll regroup, two balls, one strike, one out. Pitch, ground ball to third base, fair. Third baseman unable to field it. We're going to have runners on the corners as Kilburn breaks to second base, and she will reach second base. Credit Haley Kilburn with a single. She went to second on the throw to third. Good base running by Maddie Green going all the way around to third base. Third hit of the first inning for the Ashland Kittens.
Now batting number 9, Sydney Campbell.
And that'll bring up the catcher for Ashland, number 9, Sydney Campbell. Campbell hitting from the right side can do a lot of damage early for the Ashland Kittens. They're up 1-0 with runners on second and third. Still only one out. That ball out of the zone, one ball and no strikes. Pitch by Robinson. High and away, two balls and no strikes. As I mentioned, it is senior night here on the campus of Cocoa High School, Tigers with four seniors. All in the starting lineup tonight. Foul ball, foul territory. First baseman camps under and makes the catch. Nice play by Corey Maxwell of the Cocoa Tigers to retire Sydney Campbell. She pops up for the second out.
Now batting number 32.
And that'll bring
Maddie
up the first
Schivel.
Baseman for Ashland, number 32, Maddie Schivel. If Robinson can get out of this mess, the Tigers will consider themselves lucky to be down only by a score of 1-0. First pitch, get down the right field side, foul territory. Right fielder Shai LaTrue unable to track that one down. It's a long strike, no balls, and one strike on Shivel. Olivia McKenzie on deck for the Kittens. Just by Robinson, fouled up, fouled over my head about 10 feet. Thank goodness, getting mighty close to the table. I'm lined up. I'm looking right down the third baseline. So I'm on the right field side, right at home plate. Got a great view of it on the bright sun. Ground ball to the shortstop. 6-3 put out as Maddie Shirley takes three steps and trips. So it's an easy 6-3 put out for the Cocoa Tigers. But for the Ashland Kittens in the top of the first inning, they pick up one run on three hits, no errors, and two runners left. After one half inning of play tonight, the Ashland Kittens won. The Cocoa Tigers come in the bat. We'd like to thank Beef O'Brady's State Road 524 in Cocoa. Sean O'Reilly and the whole gang of Beefs have always been big supporters of local sports, and the tie-in with the Friday Night Locker Room is a natural. The menu includes chicken, steak, and fish taco baskets, and of course, wings. Thanks to Sean O'Reilly, Beef O'Brady's State Road 524 in Cocoa. We'll set the defense for the Ashland Kittens. Out in left field, Olivia McKenzie. Center fielder, Gabby Ingram. Right fielder, Megan Atkins. Going around the horn in the infield, third baseman, Haley Kilburn. Shortstop, Katie Baldock. Second baseman, Caitlin McKenzie. First baseman, the Kittens, Maddie Shivel. The battery tonight, the Ashland Kittens. Behind home plate, Sydney Campbell. And in the circle, Megan Murphy. Started defensively for the Ashland Kittens. We'd also like to thank Knudsen Brain Spine Injury Law Office. Law Office, they provide representation for members of the public who have suffered head trauma or a brain or spinal cord injury. Knudsen Brain Spine Injury Law Office is located in Rockledge at 830 Executive Lane, Suite 140. Phone number for Jim Knudsen is 632-2722. Couple of shout outs to the Ashton Kittens. From Megan Atkins, wearing number 11, says, I love you, Grammy and Poppy. How about a note from Maddie Shivel? Shout out to her friends and family in Ashland.
Leading off for the Tigers on the bottom of the first inning, number 2, Abby Sullivan.
Tonight for the Kittens, says, go Kittens. Grams and Pop Pop, I love you. That's from Sydney. As we move to the bottom of inning number 1, it'll be Abby Sullivan, Corey Maxner, and Mayanna Robinson. First pitch by Murphy. Call strike, no balls, and one strike. Stepping back into the box, Sullivan hitting from the right side, squares the bunt, pushes it foul down the first base side. Quickly in a hole, no balls and two strikes. Sullivan made a nice play to end the top of the first inning. She had a couple of putouts defensively in the top of the first. 0-2 pitch coming from Murphy. Here's the windup. Just a little outside. One ball and two strikes. Wow. 1-2 pitch set to come from Megan Murphy. Just a little low, evens it up. At 2-2, Kittens score early, the top of the first inning, three base hits. Gabby Ingram led off the game with a double. She eventually scored. Megan Murphy and Haley Kilburn both had singles. Foul ball down the first base side, out of play. Count remains 2-2. Credit Megan Murphy, the pitcher for the Kittens, with an RBI single in the top of the first inning. Murphy now has the softball in her hand, retrieved from the right field side in foul territory. 2-2 pitch coming to Sullivan. let up pitch, high and inside. It's run the count full to the Cocoa Tigers leadoff batter. Defensively, the Kittens, first baseman's in about 4 or 5 steps, third baseman maybe 2 or 3 steps. Second baseman shortstop, a normal dip. Swing and miss, strike 3, Sullivan goes down for the first out in the bottom of
inning number 1. Now batting number 4, senior Corey Maxner.
And that'll bring up the first baseman for the Tigers, Corey Maxner. Maxner takes a quick glance into the third base box. Head coach Mike Lawson, Maxner hitting from the right side, wearing number 4. First pitch, fastball high and away, 1 ball and no strikes. On one of 4 seniors for the Cocoa Tigers in the starting lineup on senior night, Corey Maxner, Alyssa Murphy, Cassidy Metzger, and Shyla True are the senior starters tonight for the Tigers. Swing and a miss. Maxner swings through that pitch. Evens it up at 1 ball and 1 strike. Stepping back into the box, here's the pitch. Shows bunt, pulls it back. Call strike, probably if her intent was to lay one down, she probably should have left the bat out there. 1 ball and 2 strikes on Corey Maxman. Mianna Robinson on deck for the Tigers. Pitch by Murphy, ground ball to second base. Sue Hopper bobbled, but regained her composure, making the throw to first. Nice play defensively by
Caitlin
McKenzie.
Mianna Robinson
to second base. She initially bobbled it, stayed with it. Record that as a 4-3 putout. And that'll bring up the pitcher, number 19, Mianna Robinson. Robinson hitting from the right side. Here's the pitch by her counterpart. Off-speed pitch, strike. No balls and 1 strike. Nice pitch by Megan Murphy. Outfield played straight up. Pitch swing and a miss. Quickly, Robinson in the hole. No balls and 2 strikes. There are 2 outs in the bottom of the first inning. Kittens on top of the Tigers, 1-0. Robinson deep in the batter's box. Here's a pitch by Murphy. Tried to get her to chase one out of the box. She did not. Has run the count to 1 ball and 2 strikes. There are 2 outs. No runners on for the Tigers. The pitch by Megan Murphy coming up. Foul ball straight back towards the fence. Towards me. Count remains 1-2. Robinson doing what she can to battle Megan Murphy, who's been impressive early in the first inning. Pitch by Murphy is low, evens it up in 2-2. Deuces across the bottom of the board, 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Ashland up 1-0 early in this softball game. Pitch by Megan Murphy. Just a little low has run the count full. One of those pitches that probably could have gone either way. Umpire said it was a little low. 3 balls, 2 strikes on the Tigers pitcher. Murphy steps out of the circle just for a minute. Now she's ready to throw the payoff pitch. Swing, just getting a piece of it is Mianna Robinson. Ball goes straight back. Nice job by the Tigers pitcher to battle here in the bottom of the first inning. Once again, Megan Murphy with softball in her hand. Pitch from the righty. Off-speed pitch. Foul down the first base side. About 3 feet foul of first base, trickled into right field. So the count will remain full at 3 balls and 2 strikes. Good crowd on hand tonight, senior night at Cocoa High School. Ashland Kittens brought a nice crowd as well. Here's the pitch. Foul ball down the third base side. Given chase, third base shortstop, left fielder. Ball falls to the ground. Haley Kilburn, Katie Baldock, Olivia McKenzie running as hard as they could towards the ball. unable to make the catch, so the count once again remains balls, two strikes. Robinson steps back into the batter's box once again. Payoff pitch, swing and a miss. Strike three. Mianna Robinson goes down on strike. So for the Cocoa Tigers in the bottom of the first inning, it'll be no runs, no hits, no errors, and no runners left. After one inning of play tonight, the Ashland Kittens from Ashland, Kentucky won the Cocoa Tigers 0-0. We'd like to thank Planet Fitness, located in Rockers Plaza at 1802 US Highway 1 in Rockers. Planet Fitness has a 23,000 square foot facility with fitness equipment and cardio machines. The phone number 321-433-1331. So we'll pause and listen to this exciting music coming to you from Cocoa High School. I know you have to hear it, but I can hear it right on the screen. As we're setting to move to the top of inning number two,
it'll
be 7-89 batters for Scott Ingram's Ashland Kittens. That'll be Olivia McKenzie, Caitlin McKenzie, and Megan Atkins. Olivia McKenzie, left fielder tonight, wearing number 21. She'll step into the batter's box, hit from the left, right side, rather. First pitch, called strike, and no balls and one strike. Caitlin McKenzie on deck, Megan Atkins in the hole.
Thank you.
That pitch inside evens up the count at one ball and one strike. Mianna Robinson in the circle for the Cocoa Tigers. That pitch fouls straight back. The Friday Night Locker Room scoreboard shows a one ball, two strike count on the Ashland Kittens left fielder, Olivia McKenzie. Mianna Robinson pitched to McKenzie. Ground ball to third base, fielded cleanly. It's a 5-3 putout. Nice throw by the third baseman for the Cocoa Tigers, Chelsea Miller. It was a two-hopper right to third base.
Now batting number 23.
Miller, rather, did not have to move a muscle.
Caitlin McKenzie.
So that'll bring up the second baseman for the Kittens, number 23, Caitlin McKenzie. The first eight batters have hit from the right side for the Kittens. That pitch low. Megan Atkins on deck for Coach Scott Ingram's Ashland Kittens. We are on the top of the second inning. The Kittens won, the Tigers nothing. That pitch high, two balls and no strikes. Once again, beautiful evening in Cocoa. Not a cloud in the sky. Breeze still blowing from the right field side to the left field side. Call strike, two balls and one strike. Kittens scored one run in the top of the first inning. Gabby Ingram led off with a double. She was eventually brought home by Megan Murphy. Ground ball foul down the third base side. Shows two balls and two strikes. Mianna Robinson once again with a pitch. Ground ball to third base, fielded nicely. High throw. Gets past the first baseman. We're going to credit McKenzie with a base hit. Although the throw was high, I think she's going to beat the throw. Sullivan did a nice job going to her right into the hole to keep the ball from getting into left field. So credit Caitlin McKenzie with an infield hit. That'll put a Kitten runner on first with one out in the top of the second inning and bring up the right fielder, Megan Atkins. the first lefty we've seen at the plate tonight. Right fielder number 11. In the batter's box, deep, runs up like she's going to either bunt or slap. At the softball, that pitch low, one ball and no strikes on Atkins. Gabby Ingram on deck for the Ashland Kittens. Foul ball, Atkins takes a step moving towards the pitcher's mound. I don't know that she intended to make contact with that one, but she did. So now the count shows one ball and one strike. Pitch by Robinson, tries to put down a bunt, pops it straight back. Ashland 1, Coco nothing. We are in the top of the second inning. Megan Atkins takes a quick glance to the coach in the first base box, steps back into the box. From the left side, the 1-2 pitch from Robinson. Offers at it on the bunt. She misses it. Strike 3. Megan Atkins goes down on strikes.
Now batting number 2, Gabby Ingram.
That'll get the Kittens back up to the top of their lineup and bring up the center fielder, number 2, Gabby Ingram. Ingram led off his contest with a double and eventually scored off of the base hit from Megan Murphy. First pitch high and outside, one ball and no strikes on the Kittens center fielder. Caitlin McKenzie, your runner on first base for the Ashland Kittens. They come into the contest with a 9-2 record on the year. Base hit to the right field. It's not going to be at least 2 for Ingram. Coach Ingram is going to stop the runner at third. Had thoughts of sending McKenzie. He decided not to do that. So now the Kittens will have runners on second and third with 2 outs in the top of the second inning. That's the second base hit for Gabby Ingram.
Now batting number 14.
And that'll bring up the shortstop, number 14, Katie Baldock. Reminiscent of last half inning, the Kittens had runners on second and third with 2 out, unable to really break it open. Same situation, runners on second and third, 2 outs. Let's see if Robinson can work her way out of this jam. Katie Baldock looks at the first pitch, call strike. No balls in 1 strike on the Kittens' shortstop. Baldock grounded out to the shortstop in the first inning. That pitch just out of the zone evens it up at 1-1. Caitlin McKenzie on third. Gabby Ingram on second for the Kittens. They're up 1-0, threatening to add to this lead. Ground ball to third base, foul by about a foot. So that'll run the count to 1 ball and 2 strikes on Baldock. Ingram goes back to second. McKenzie goes back to third. Megan Murphy on deck for the Ashland Kittens. That ball outside. Robinson trying to get Baldock to chase one out of the zone. She did not. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Once again, Robinson one pitch away from getting out of this jam. Baldock one pitch away from making the Tigers pay for it. That pitch fouled out of play. Count remains even at 2-2. Big pitch coming up once again by Mayanna Robinson of the Cocoa Tigers. Ground ball to third base. Unable to field it. 1 run will score. 2 runs will score. The ball was hit to the third baseman. That's Kira Davis, who had shifted over to third base. It hopped off of her glove into left field. So 2 runners will cross home plate for the Kittens in the top of the second in the persons of Caitlin McKenzie and Gabby Ingram.
How about number 12, Megan Murphy?
We go, Murph.
Tough break for the Cocoa Tigers. That'll bring up the pitcher for the Kittens, number 12, Megan Murphy. Murphy had an RBI single in the top of the first inning. Ashland up 3-0. Still 2 outs in the top of the second. Katie Baldock, the runner on first base for Ashland. That pitch low, 2 balls and no strikes on Murphy. Tigers would like to stop it right here. They're down 3-0 early. A lot of softball yet to be played tonight. That ball hits home plate, gets past the catcher, easily advancing to second base. This is Katie Baldock.
It's a run.
Wild pitch thrown by Mianna Robinson. So now the Kittens have a runner on second with two outs in the top of the second. They're about a score of 3-0 over the Coco Tigers. Mianna Robinson takes a quick glance over her shoulder, looking at the base runner, Katie Baldock. Now moves to the rubber. Here's the pitch. Nice pitch. Hits the inside corner. Three balls and one strike to the Ashland Kittens pitcher, Megan Murphy. Haley Kilburn on deck. That pitch is out of the zone. Good eye by Megan Murphy. Good plate discipline. Could have been easy to chase that when she did not. So that'll put Kittens runners on first and second with two outs. Still in the top of the second inning, Ashland up 3-0. And we'll bring the cleanup hitter for the Ashland Kittens.
Haley Kilburn.
Third baseman number 51, Haley Kilburn.
Running number 8, Maddie Green.
Kilburn's 1-for-1 tonight. She singled in the first inning. Sydney Campbell is on deck for Ashland. That pitch just a little low, one ball and no strikes. Sometimes that third out is so difficult to record that Coco Tigers are finding that to be the case here in the top of the second inning. Two of the first three batters were outs for the Tigers, and then all of a sudden they just cannot get that third out. That pitch out of the zone, two balls and no strikes. Ground ball foul down third base, not by more than a foot. A well-hit ball by Kilburn. Just got out in front of that one just a little bit. Count will show two balls and one strike on the Ashland third baseman. Another foot to the right. That one's fair, and at least one runner will score. Pitch by Mianna Robinson. Foul down the left field line, out of play. Alyssa Murphy giving it a chase, the left fielder for the Tigers. She ran out of room. Once again, deuces wild across the bottom of the scoreboard. Two balls, two strikes, and two outs. Ashland 3, Coco nothing in the top of inning number 2. 2-2 pitch. Foul straight back, out of play. Count will remain 2-2. We'd like to thank Florida Master Temp, located at 3475 North Highway US 1 in Coco. Florida Master Temp is an authorized sales and service outlet for air conditioning systems, refrigeration equipment, ice making equipment, and machines. The office phone is answered 24 hours a day. 2-2 pitch on the way. A foul ball down the third base side. Once again, a hard hit foul ball by Haley Kilburn. She's given mine to Robinson Fitz.
We got 5-1, base hit.
We are in the top of inning number 2. Ashland 3, Coco nothing. Tigers trying to stop it right there. The Kittens trying to add to the 3-run lead. Foul ball straight back, out of play once again. If this were a baseball game, it would be a good thing. You're wearing the pitcher out, making her throw pitches. Not much importance in softball. You can throw balls all night long from the circle to softball. Off-speed pitch, call strike, pitcher drops the ball, throws down the first base to record the third out in the top of the second inning. So for the Ashland Kittens, in the top of the second, they come with two runs on two hits, one error, and two runners left. After an inning and a half of play tonight, the Ashland Kittens 3, the Coco Tigers nothing. We'd like to thank Al's Trophy Shop, 2 Brevard County locations, one on Palm Bay Road in Palm Bay, and the other in Coco on US 1, just north of the beach line. Now, let's listen to some cool music.
Jesus.
Leading off for the Tigers in the bottom of the second, number 44, Alyssa Murphy.
Chelsea Miller and Kayla Anderson for the Cocoa Tigers. Tigers find themselves down by a score of 3-0 to Ashland Kittens out of Ashland, Kentucky. Kittens down on spring break, playing in the tournament sponsored by Space Coast Daily. Charles Malone, Tom Palermo, first pitch fouled out of play down the right field side. No balls and one strike. A terrific job done each and every tournament by the crew at Space Coast Daily. They brought in quite a few baseball and softball teams last week. Doing the same thing again this week, spring break. 0-1 pitch to Murphy, just a little low. Evens it up at 1-1, one ball and one strike. Third baseman for the Kittens, Haley Kilburn, in about two steps. First baseman in about three or four steps. First baseman, Maddie Shivel, swing and miss. Has run the count to 1-2 on the Cocoa Tigers left fielder. This is senior night, number 44. Your batter is one of four seniors for Mike Lawson's Cocoa Tigers. Murphy deep in the batter's box. Swing and miss, strike three. Murphy chases one high out of the zone and goes down on strikes.
Now batting 0-1, Chelsea Miller.
That'll bring up the third baseman for the Cocoa Tigers, number 0-1, Chelsea Miller. On deck, designated player number 99, Kayla Anderson. Miller's first at bat tonight. She's hitting from the right side. She's deep in the box. About to set to face the hard-throwing Megan Murphy of the Kittens. First pitch. Not quite there. One ball and no strikes for Chelsea Miller. Quick glance at third now. Right back into the box is Miller. Nice pitch. Evens it up at 1-1. Miller started the game at third base. We did notice that Kira Davis moved over there last half inning. We don't get the position changes or lineup changes here at the table, so it's something we try to pick up throughout the course of the game as best we can. Pitch by Murphy. Nice pitch on the corner. One ball and two strikes on Chelsea Miller. Miller takes a quick glance to the first base dugout where her coaches and teammates are. Off-speed pitch just misses outside. Reds run the count even. Two balls and two strikes. There are one out in the bottom of the second. Kittens 3, Tigers nothing. Miller steps back into the box as Murphy gets her sign. The pitch by the righty. Low and inside. He's run the count full. The Tigers need base runners. They're down by 3 in the bottom of the second inning. There is one out. Miller steps back in. She's awaiting the payoff pitch now. Murphy backs off just a minute. Payoff pitch by Megan Murphy. Ground ball to shortstop. A two-hopper. Nice play by the first baseman, Maddie Shivel. The throw was a little bit wide towards the home plate side. She put the tag on Chelsea Miller. So now there are two outs in the bottom of the second. And that'll bring
now
up the Cocoa
Tigers
designated player number 99, Kayla Anderson. Anderson hitting from the right side, calls timeout from home plate umpire. Now she's ready. She's deep in the batter's box as well. First pitch by Murphy. Right at the knees, called strike. No balls and one strike. Nice pitch by Megan Murphy. We're still early in the game. There are 5 consecutive outs recorded by Megan Murphy. Swing and miss. Quickly, Anderson's in a hole. No balls and two strikes. Murphy in complete control up to this point. The 0-2 pitch by Murphy coming up. Foul just gets a piece of it. Does Kayla Anderson go straight back? So the count will remain no balls and two strikes on the designated player for the Cocoa Tigers, Kayla Anderson. Megan Murphy gets a little dirt on her right hand. She's ready to throw the 0-2 pitch. Ground ball up the middle. Base hit. First base hit of the night for the Cocoa Tigers. Kayla Anderson drives it right back up the middle. So that'll put a Cocoa Tiger
now batting number 43,
with two
Kira
outs
Davis
in the bottom of the second inning. And bring up third baseman number 43, Kira Davis. We'll try to pick up the position change when the Tigers go back out into the field. We'll see where Chelsea Miller moved to. Davis started at second base, so she probably just switched positions with her. Davis hitting from the right side, swings and fouls the first pitch towards the right side into the screen. No balls and one strike on the Tigers' third baseman. Davis wearing number 43, hitting in the number 7 slot. All-speed pitch way out in front. Snap throw to first base. Getting back easily is Kayla Anderson, but it was a nice off-speed pitch by Megan Murphy. Now Davis is quickly in a hole. No balls and two strikes with two outs. First squad down by 3.
Get the batter, Murph.
0-2 pitch coming from Murphy. Just misses. One ball and two strikes. The crowd on the right field side wanted it. Umpire said, nope, not quite. Cassidy Metzger on deck for the Cocoa Tigers, hoping to come to bat this half inning. Swing and miss. Strike 3. Kira Davis goes down on strike. So for the Cocoa Tigers in the bottom of the second inning, no runs, one hit, no errors, and one runner left. After 2 innings of play tonight, the Ashland Kittens from Ashland, Kentucky, 3, the Cocoa Tigers, 0. We'd like to thank Community Bank of the South. 3 locations, one at 277 North Sykes Creek Parkway in Merritt Island, one at State Road 524 in Cocoa, and one at 1902 South Fisk Boulevard in Rockledge. As we're set to move to the top of inning number 3, it'll be the number 5, 6, and 7 batters for
leading off for Ashland in the top of the third, number 9, Sydney Campbell.
That'll be Sydney Campbell, Maddie Schivel, and Olivia McKenzie hitting 1, 2, 3 in the top of the third inning. Number 8 for 43 for the Tigers, McKenzie Hoffman coming in place of Kira Davis. She should be batting in the number 7 slot. We'll pick it up when she comes to bat. I do not see her in the field. Yeah, she's playing third base. First pitch by Sydney Campbell outside. One ball and no strikes. So Mackenzie Hoffman has entered the game for the Tigers playing third base. She'll bat in the number 7 slot. Next pitch by Robinson. High and away. Two balls and no strikes. Yeah. 2-0 pitch coming up to Campbell is low, 3-0. Campbell 0-for-1 tonight. She looks at ball 4, so Campbell reaches first base for the first time tonight, leading off the top of the third inning. That'll put an Ashland Kittens runner on first with nobody out. And bring out the first baseman, number 32, Maddie Schivel.
Now batting number 32, Maddie Schivel.
Schivel grounded out to the shortstop in
running
the first inning.
Caitlin Ferguson.
Ashland 3, Cocoa nothing.
We got 3-2.
Schivel stepping in from the right side. Drop ball down. Base hit by Silver over the head of the third baseman. Had to wait just a minute to see if she could get to the ball. She could not. So Maddie Silver records her first base hit of tonight, pushing Sydney Campbell to second base.
Now batting number 21, Olivia McKenzie.
And that'll bring up the left fielder for the Kittens, number 21, Olivia McKenzie. Ashland threatening once again in the top of the third inning. They are up by a score of 3-0.
Good bunt.
Bunt down third base side. There's no way to let your head out. A great bunt by Olivia McKenzie. Is loaded the bases for the Ashland Kittens with nobody out. Campbell sliding over to third base for Maddie Schivel, the runner at second base for the Kittens. Now the Tigers in all sorts of trouble. They're down 3-0 in the top of the third inning. The Kittens threatening to blow it wide open. Caitlin McKenzie looks at the first pitch outside, one ball and no strike. Nobody out in the top of the third inning. Megan Atkins on deck. Ball hit to center field. Should be caught by the center fielder. Tagging and scoring easily from third base. The runner at second advances to third. The runner at first base hook. To credit Caitlin McKenzie with a sack fly and an RBI, Sydney Campbell will easily score from third base with the fourth.
Now batting number 11, Megan Atkins.
Maddie Schivel at third base now. Olivia McKenzie still standing on first. Timeout called by Mike Lawson of the Cocoa Tigers. He's going to have a word with his pitcher. Mayanna Robinson is all of the Tigers from the infield. Meet in the circle. We'd like to thank Custom Print Screen Printing, located at 1740 South Huntington Lane in Rockledge. Custom Prints provides textile printing products for family reunions, church gatherings, civic organizations, sports team uniforms, and business shirts. Custom Prints office phone 631-3652. We'd also like to thank Jimmy's Restaurant. One Jimmy's Restaurant is located in Rockledge at 1279 Admiralty Boulevard next to Turtle Creek Golf Club. The other one is located in Port St. John on US 1. That's Jimmy's Restaurant in Rockledge and Jimmy's Restaurant US 1. So Mayanna Robinson will stay put in the circle. The meeting has broken. Megan Atkins just about ready to step into the batter's box for the Kittens. It's Ashland 4, Coco nothing. Kittens with runners on the corners, nobody out in the top of the third inning.
We're going ones right
Atkins
here.
0 for 1 tonight. She struck out in the second inning, pitched by Robinson. Atkins starts deep in the box. She has that crossover step. She moves towards the pitcher as the pitch is thrown. First pitch in the dirt away. One ball and no strikes. Nice stop by Madison Lawson, the catcher for the Coco Tigers. Bunt back to the pitcher. She's going to go to first to take the out. Nice play on a bang-bang play. Third base runner unable to advance. A well-played defensive ball by Mayanna Robinson. The ball was hit right back to her. She looked the runner back at third.
How about it, number two, Gabby Ingram?
And then flipped the ball to first place. A very close play at first. But now there are two outs. That'll get the Kittens back up to the top of their lineup as Gabby Ingram looks at ball one. Olivia McKenzie did advance to second on the bunt back to the pitcher. So now the Kittens with runners on second and third with two outs. Ingram 2 for 2 tonight. Pitch hits the dirt in front of the home plate. Once again, a nice stop by Madison Lawson. Probably just saved one run. So for the third consecutive inning, the Kittens have runners on second and third with two outs. Tigers dodged a bullet in the first inning. They did not in the second inning. Nice pitch. Call strike, two balls and one strike on the Ashland Kittens center fielder, Gabby Ingram. As I mentioned, Ingram 2 for 2 tonight and scored two runs. Ground ball foul down the third base side. Count remains full at 2-2. Ashland 4, Coco nothing. Ashland Kittens from Ashland, Kentucky on spring break. picked a great week weather-wise. It absolutely could not be better. Ball hit down the left field side in foul territory, giving chase, dropping to the ground. Good hustle once again by the left fielder, Alyssa Murphy of the Cocoa Tigers. A long strike count remains. Two balls and two strikes.
Line drive, two, line drive.
Ingram hit the ball well. It probably were about a one or two hopper to the fence in foul territory. After giving chase to that foul ball, Alyssa Murphy hits the fence. They're going to give her just a minute to catch her breath. Coach Lawson takes a few steps out to make sure Murphy's okay. She says she's fine. So we're about ready to resume play. Kittens with runners on second and third. Up 4-0. Two outs, two balls, two strike pitch. Just misses the zone. Nice plate discipline by Gabby Ingram. Holding off on that swing. Now the count's run full to the Kitten center fielder. Pitch by Robinson. Ground ball. A base hit. One run will score. Two runs will score. The ball was kept in the infield, but the hustle of Olivia McKenzie going all the way around to score the second run off of that base hit. Chivel scores easily. McKenzie scores from second. So that was the third base hit of this contest for Gabby Ingram. Credit Gabby with two RBIs. So now the Kittens up by a score of 6-0. Still two out.
Now batting number 14, Katie Baldock.
It's Katie Baldock is just about ready to step into the batter's box. She's 0-2 tonight. Ground out to the shortstop in the first base. Swings at the first pitch. Foul ball down the third base side. She reached on an error in the second inning. Megan Murphy on deck for the Ashland Kittens.
Here go, 1-4.
Once again, so many times it's such a challenge to get that third out. You get two outs, two quick outs, and all of a sudden you absolutely cannot get the third out, and that's what's happened tonight on two occasions, breaking for second base. Reaching second base safely is Gabby Ingram. Good hustle by the Kittens center fielder.
There she is, 1-4, right here. Here we go.
As the base pops up, Gabby puts it back down into the ground. Not only is she fast, she does a little maintenance at second base. One ball, one strike on Katie Baldock.
Here go, 1-4.
Pitch by Robinson. Well hit. Making chase. Great catch by the right fielder of the Cocoa Tigers off of the well hit ball. Looked like it was going to be in the gap. Right fielder Shyla True took off after it. Ball hit her glove. For the third out in the top of the third inning. So for the Ashland Kittens, in the top of the third, they come up with three runs on three hits, no errors, and one runner left on base, after 2.5 innings of play tonight. And 6, Coco nothing.
Leading off for the Tigers in the bottom of the third, number 13, senior Cassidy Metzger.
For the Cocoa Tigers, it'll be Cassidy Metzger, Madison Lawson, and Abby Sullivan. Metzger hitting in the number 8 slot for Mike Lawson's Cocoa Tigers. She's one of 4 seniors starting tonight on senior night. First pitch by Megan Murphy outside, 1 ball and no strikes. The Ashland Kittens from Ashland, Kentucky, 6. The Cocoa Tigers, nothing. Here in the bottom of inning number 3. Pitch by the righty. Low and inside. 2 balls and no strikes on Metzger. Madison Lawson, the catcher for the Tigers, on deck. Abby Sullivan in the hole. This is the first plate appearance tonight by Cassidy Metzger. The 2-0 pitch. Swings at one. Might have been just a little high. 2 balls and 1 strike on the Tigers center fielder. Wind has appeared to die down just a little bit. Ball out of the zone, high and away, 3-1. When the game first started, it was pretty strong from the right field side to the left field side. Just a little breeze still, but I don't know that it's quite as strong as it was. Really hasn't had much, if any, impact on the contest tonight. Pitch by Murphy. Just a little high. Ball 4, Cassidy Metzger starts the bottom of the third inning with a walk.
Now batting number 10, Maddie Lawson.
And that'll bring up the Tigers catcher, number 10, Madison Lawson. Lawson hitting in the number 9 slot. Tigers one batter away from getting back up to the top of their lineup. First pitch high by Murphy, 1 ball and no strikes. Great crowd, especially on the first base side, which is the visiting side from Ashland, Kentucky. They brought a tremendous crowd. Pitch by Megan Murphy. Swing and miss. Evens count up at 1 ball and 1 strike. Infield at normal depth, as is the outfield, still playing straight up. Squaring the bunt. Ball low, pulled the bat back. Snap throw to first base, getting back rather easily is Cassidy Metzger. Friday night locker room scoreboard shows 2 balls and 1 strike. 2-1 pitch just about set to come to the Tigers catcher from Megan Murphy. Here's the windup and the pitch, squaring to bunt. She bunts the ball, hits her on the leg, but she's in the box, so that evens up the count at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Maddie Lawson set for the 2-2 pitch. Tigers down 6-0 with a runner on first, nobody out. Into the gap, circling towards third base. A single for Madison Lawson, going all the way to third base is Cassidy Metzger. So for the first time
tonight, now batting number 2, Abby Sullivan.
With runners on the corners, nobody out. They are down by a score of 6-0. Looks like we're going to have a courtesy runner. Number 5, Reagan Hughes, is going to run for the Tigers catcher, Madison Lawson.
Now running number 5, Reagan Hughes.
So that'll put Hughes on first, Metzger on third, and bring up the Cocoa Tigers shortstop, number 2, Abby Sullivan. Sullivan 0-for-1 tonight. She struck out to lead off the bottom of the first inning for the Tigers. First pitch by Murphy. Off-speed pitch hit to center field. Caught in, the throw home. It's going to be close. Scoring the first run of the game for the Cocoa Tigers is Cassidy Metzger. Credit Sullivan with a sacrifice fly to center field. Reagan Hughes unable to advance. She's still on first base. So it's 6-1.
Now batting number 4, Corey Maxton.
The Tigers dent the scoreboard for the first time. It was a nice throw by Gabby Ingram in center field with the speed of Metzger allowed her to score the first Cocoa Tigers run. And that'll bring up first baseman number 4, Corey Maxton. Maxton 0-for-1 tonight. Swings at the first pitch. No balls and 1 strike. Maxner ground out to the second baseman in the first inning. she is one of four seniors as well for the Cocoa Tigers here on senior night. Corey Maxner hitting from the right side. No balls, one strike, one out. Pitch by Murphy. She squares the bunt straight back towards me, which is not a good thing because I'm in foul territory, as is the ball. So it's no balls and two strikes on Maxner. Megan Murphy ahead of the batter. No balls and two strikes, one out. In the bottom of the third, the Tigers down by 5 runs, 6-1 to the visiting Ashland Kittens out of Ashland, Kentucky. Pitch by Murphy is outside. Reagan Hughes takes 3 or 4 steps off, gets back to first base. Catcher for the Kittens, Sydney Campbell, acts like she was going to throw down to first. She decided not to, which is probably a smart thing to do. Hughes not far enough off of first base, but I know she's trying to keep her close to first base, not necessarily trying to pick her off, but trying to keep her close. Pitch by Murphy. Swing in the foul territory down the right field side. Good hustle by the Kittens. Second baseman and right fielder. That's Caitlin McKenzie. And Megan Atkins giving chase. Ball fouls to the ground. 1 ball and 2 strikes on Maxner. Megan Murphy still in the circle. High pitch. Out of the zone, evens it up at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Ashland 6, Cocoa 1. Bottom of inning number 3 as Corey Maxner steps back into the batter's box. The senior just gets a piece of that one. Dribbles out 2 or 3 feet in front of home plate after bouncing off of her leg. So the count remains even at 2-2. Tigers trying to chip away at this, what is now a 5-run Ashland lead. Kittens leading 6-0. Coming into the bottom of the third inning, Coco picks up 1 run as Maxner swings through that pitch and goes down on strikes.
Now batting number 19, Bayana Robinson.
So then now they're 2 outs in the bottom of inning number 3, and that'll bring up the Tigers pitcher, number 19, Bayana Robinson. Reagan Hughes still standing in first base for the Cocoa Tigers. Megan Murphy gets her signal from catcher Sydney Campbell. Now Campbell squats. Here's the pitch by Murphy. High pass the catcher. Wild pitch will easily allow Reagan Hughes to move over to second base. That one just got away from Murphy. She hasn't thrown too many pitches like that tonight. Held on to that one a little bit too long. It was about 2 feet over the head of catcher Sydney Campbell. Campbell had no possibility whatsoever to snag that one. So it's a 1-ball, no-strike pitch to Myanna Robinson coming up. Off-speed pitches high, 2 balls and no strikes. Once again, I'm Steve Wilson of the Friday Night Locker Room, a special Friday night edition of the Friday Night Locker Room. I guess we'll call it a Tuesday Night Locker Room show tonight. Here's the pitch. It is low and inside, 3 balls and no strikes. We cover all high schools in Brevard County there. Between baseball and softball, there are 42 teams at play, 21 softball teams and 21 baseball teams. So we get around the county and cover them all. It's Cocoa Tigers, Ashland Kittens. Game tonight, call strike, 3 balls and 1 strike. Robinson thought that was out of the zone. She was about ready to cross the bat and walk down the first base. Umpire said, nope. That one is in the zone. 3-1 pitch coming up to the Tigers pitcher. Fouled out of play down the right field side. Now has run the count full, 3 balls and 2 strikes. There are 2 outs in the bottom of inning number 3. Megan Murphy, 1 pitch away from getting out of this inning. Pitch by Murphy, off-speed pitch, high, 4. Myanna Robinson will walk to first base. And that'll put Coco Tiger
number 44, senior,
on first and second, with two out in the bottom of the first inning, down 6-1. Quick timeout called as Savannah Pruitt is inserted into the game. She's going to run for the pitcher, Mianna Robinson.
Run so for the Pruitt Tigers, will be on first Savannah base. Pruitt.
Maddie Lawson on second base. Excuse me, Reagan Hughes, because she's running for Lawson. That'll bring up the left fielder, number 44, Alyssa Murphy. Ground ball back to the pitcher. Fielded cleanly, should be an easy put out, and it is. Nice job by Megan Murphy of the Ashland Kittens to retire Alyssa Murphy. So for the Coco Tigers in the bottom of the third inning, they come up with one run on one hit. No errors and two runners left. After three complete innings of play, the Ashland Kittens 6, Coco Tigers 1. As we move to the top of the fourth inning for the Ashland Kittens, it will be Megan Murphy, Haley Kilburn, and Sydney Campbell, the 3, 4, and 5 hitters for the Kittens. Murphy 2 for 2 tonight. She had an RBI single in the first inning, and she had a base hit in the second inning. Maybe an infield hit. The speed of Megan Murphy, the ball went over the head of the pitcher towards second base. Second baseman and shortstop for the Tigers converged at the same time. Neither one could get to the ball to record the putout. So Megan Murphy will reach base for the third time tonight.
Now batting number 51.
That'll put a Kittens runner on first with nobody out and bring up third baseman number 51, Haley Kilburn. Gilbert's 1 for 2 tonight. She singled in the first inning. Struck out in the second inning. Pop up for the shortstop. Sullivan Henry fires across the diamond to double off the base runner. So bang, bang, just like that. There are two outs in the top of the fourth inning. It was a well-hit ball to Kilburn right at the shortstop, Abby Sullivan.
Now batting number 9, Sydney Campbell.
First base runner had broken. So she was easily doubled. Oh, so another two outs in the top of the fourth. That'll bring up the catcher, number 9, Sydney Campbell. Campbell looks at the first pitch. Ball, 1 ball, and no strike. She's 0 for 1 tonight. She popped up to the second baseman at the first inning. She walked and scored a run in the third inning. Call strike evens it up at 1-1. Maddie Schivel on deck for the Kittens. Line drive, base hit to left field. Stopping at first base is Sydney Campbell. So she'll reach base for the second time tonight. A well-hit ball to left field. Gotten in quickly by the left fielder, Alyssa Murphy.
Now batting number 32, Maddie Schivel.
And that'll put a Kittens runner on first with two outs in the top of the fourth inning and bring up first baseman number 32, Maddie Schivel. Schivel's 1 for 2 tonight. pop up to center field, taking 5, 6, 7, 8 steps in, making the catch in center field, is the senior, number 13, Cassidy Metzger. So for the Kittens, in the top of inning number 4, they come up with no runs on 2 hits, no errors. No runners left still, 6-1.
Leading off for the Tigers in the bottom of the 4th, number 01, Chelsea Miller.
As we're set to move to the bottom of the 4th inning. Chelsea Miller stepping into the box. The Cocoa Tigers hitting from the right side. Tigers down 6-1. Bottom of the 4th inning, Megan Murphy still in the circle for the Ashland Kittens. First pitch called strike, no balls and 1 strike. Chelsea Miller 0-1 tonight. She ground out to the shortstop in the 2nd inning. Pitch by Murphy, call strike. On the outside corner, 2 nice pitches thrown by number 12. No balls and 2 strikes on Miller. Miller wearing number 01 tonight. Pitch by Murphy, fouled out of play. Count remains 0-2. Ball thrown back into play. Chelsea Miller, rather, leading off to the bottom of the 4th inning. Tigers down 6-1. Last half inning was the first time Ashland has not scored in an inning tonight. That pitch high and outside has run the count to 1-2 strikes. Kayla Anderson on deck. Mackenzie Hoffman in the hole for the Cocoa Tigers. Miller trying to get something started offensively for Coach Mike Lawson's Cocoa Tigers. Swing and a miss. Strike 3. Number 01 goes down on strike.
Now batting number 99, Kayla Anderson.
And that'll bring up tonight's designated player. Number 99, Kayla Anderson. Anderson 1-1 tonight. She recorded the first base hit of the contest for the Cocoa Tigers with a single in the 2nd inning. Swings at a high strike, no balls and 1 strike. The Ashland Kittens will play the Merritt Island Mustangs tomorrow. Unfortunately, we will not be able to bring that to you. Count evens up at 1-1. City Council meeting tomorrow night. Got to go to work with my real job, so got to do what you got to do. Megan Murphy all set for the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike 2. Nice pitch at the knees. That would have been a tough one to hit, but it was in the zone. Anderson had to go after it. 1-2 strikes on number 99 for the Cocoa Tigers. Megan Murphy in the circle has had a nice game tonight. Both in the circle. Swing and a miss. Strike 3. Anderson goes down on strike. But offensively as well, Murphy.
Now batting number 8, Mackenzie Hoffman.
Stand on the box, stomp your feet, stop clapping. Got a real good feeling, so I'm gonna die.
Tigers third baseman, number 8, Mackenzie Hoffman, her first plate appearance tonight. Ball 1, she was inserted in the number 7 slot in place of Kira Davis. Hoffman hitting from the right side. Here's the pitch by Murphy. Nice pitch. Evens it up for 1 ball and 1 strike. Megan Murphy's pitch just misses outside. Note from Megan and Ryan, hope you're feeling better, Dad. We love you. That is for Megan and Ryan. Megan Atkins would also like to say hi, Grammy and Poppy. Nice pitch thrown by Murphy. Evens the count up with 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Hoffman steps back into the batter's box, hitting from the right side. Here's the pitch by Murphy. Foul down the first base side. Get hustled by Maddie Shivel, unable to corral that one. So the count will remain 2-2 on the Tigers' third baseman, Cassidy Metzger, on deck. Megan Murphy set for the pitch. Off-speed pitch, just getting a piece of it is Mackenzie Hoffman. Nice swing at that one. It could have been easy to be out in front and miss that one. It's a nice pitch thrown by Megan Murphy. Hoffman stays alive to at least see 1 more pitch. Count remains 2-2. Foul ball straight back towards me once again, which means it is foul. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Ashland 6, Coco 1. We're in the bottom of the 4th inning. This is a regulation 7-inning softball game between the Kittens and the Tigers. 2-2 pitch. Swing and miss. Strike 3. Mackenzie Hoffman goes down on strikes. Megan Murphy strikes out the side for the Tigers in the bottom of the 4th inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, and no runners left. After 4 innings of play tonight, Ashland 6, Coco 1. We'd like to thank once again Microman Nissan Cadillac, located on the 520 Causeway, Merritt Island. Time to crank up the music once again. We are right underneath the speakers.
Truly, I ain't got no business ever since my friends are here. I just came to kick it, but really, I would rather be at home all by myself, not in this room with people who don't even care about my well-being. My old ass, your ass, I don't need a boyfriend. So if you can't go back, please enjoy your party. I'll be here.
So as we move to the top of inning number 5,
Ashland at the top of the
87-89 batters for Coach Scott Ingram's Ashland Kittens, Olivia McKenzie, Caitlin McKenzie, and Megan Atkins. Kittens on top of the Tigers, 6-1. Olivia McKenzie stepping into the batter's box, hitting from the right side. She is 1-for-2 tonight. First pitch in the dirt, 1 ball and no strikes. McKenzie ground out to the third baseman in the 2nd inning. She laid down a nice bunt in the 3rd inning and eventually scored what was the 6th run of this contest. The Kittens, nice pitch, evens it up at 1-1. One ball, 2 strikes, just catches the corner. Pitch by Mayanna Robinson. She's still in the circle. That one is low and away, hits the dirt, evens it up at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Take it out. 3-2 pitch hits home plate, so that'll run the count full to Olivia McKenzie.
We're going to do one drive.
Once again, McKenzie wearing number 21, playing left field for the Kittens this evening. Miana Robinson's 3-2 pitch is high, ball four. Olivia McKenzie will reach base for the second time tonight.
Now batting number 23, Caitlin McKenzie.
That'll bring up the second baseman, number 23, Caitlin McKenzie. McKenzie had a base hit in the second inning and scored a sacrifice in inning number three. She's had a nice evening, batting in the number eight slot for the Kittens. First pitch is low, one ball and no strikes. Wearing the bunt, foul ball straight back to the catcher. Trying to get Olivia McKenzie over to second base. So that'll even count up at 1-1. A lot going on this Saturday. Rockledge Relay for Life starts at 3:00 at Larry Schultz Park in Rockledge on Fisk Boulevard. Two big events Saturday night as well. We'll talk about those in just a few minutes. Trying to figure out how I can hit both of them. Bunt fair down the third base side. Nice job. It's going to be close at first. Put out. Nice play by the third baseman charging. That's McKenzie Hoffman. Caitlin McKenzie does her job, pushing Olivia McKenzie over to second
base.
Now
batting number 11, Megan Atkins.
So now there are one out in the top of the fifth inning. Kittens up 6-1 with a runner on second. And that'll bring up right fielder number 11, Megan Atkins. Atkins hitting from the left side. She's 0-2 tonight. She struck out in the second. And she ground back to the pitcher in the third inning. First pitch outside, one ball and no strikes on Atkins. Pitch by Robinson. Nice pitch. Evens it up at 1-1. Quick timeout call by the Kittens. Two big events coming up Saturday night. How in the world can I be at both? The Holy Name of Jesus Church on Indiana. It's a 1964 Beatles tribute band, which I've been looking forward to for months. But it happens to fall on the same night that the Brevard County Sheriff's Office basketball team plays a charity event against local celebrities, which we are broadcasting. So that pitch in the dirt, two balls and one strike. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to hit both of them. I've got to be on the air Saturday night, but I really, really want to go see the Beatles tribute band. So we'll see how it all shakes out. Pitch by Robinson is outside. Kittens with a runner on second, one out of the top of the fifth inning. They're up by a score of 6-1 over the Cocoa Tigers. 3-1 pitch coming, bunt right back to the pitcher. Will advance the runner to third base and gets Megan by a half a step at the most. It'll be a 1-3 putout. It was a nice bunt, doing exactly what she wanted it to do, pushing Olivia McKenzie over to third base and bringing the Kittens back up to the top of their lineup. Center fielder number 2, Gabby Ingram, 3-for-3 tonight, has scored twice, has a couple of RBIs. Pops up, shortstop has control of that behind the third baseman. Nice job by Abby Sullivan. So for the first time tonight, the Tigers retire Gabby Ingram for Ashland in the top of the fifth. No runs, no hits, no errors, and one runner left. 6-1, Ashland.
Just a small town girl, living in a lonely world. He took the midnight train going everywhere. Just a city girl, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going everywhere.
Come on.
Leading off for the Tigers at the bottom of the fifth, number 13, senior Cassidy Metzger.
As we're set to move to the bottom of the inning, number 5. It'll be center fielder number 13, Cassidy Metzger, the senior right-handed hitter in the batter's box on senior night. Megan Murphy still in the circle. First pitch is low, one ball and no strikes to Cassidy Metzger. Madison Lawson on deck, Abby Sullivan in the hole. The number 8-9 in batters for the Cocoa Tigers. Cocoa down 6-1 in the bottom of the fifth inning. Swing and a miss evens it up at 1-1. Once again, Maddie Shivel, the first baseman for the Kittens, would like to say hello to friends and family in Ashland. Foul down the first base side, one ball and two strikes. Catcher Sydney Campbell has done a nice job behind home plate. She'd like to say hello to Grams and Pop Pop. She loves you very much. From Sydney Campbell. You'd be proud of Sydney. She's playing well tonight, as are her teammates. And a note from Megan and Ryan. We hope you're feeling better, Dad. We love you. Two balls and two strikes on Metzger. 2-2 pitch coming up from Murphy. Here's the windup and the pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike 3. Cassidy Metzger goes down on strikes. That's the fourth consecutive strikeout by Megan Murphy. She struck out the side in the fourth inning. Now gets Metzger to go down on strikes to lead off the bottom of the fifth. That'll bring up the Tigers catcher, number 10, Madison Lawson. Lawson 1-for-1 tonight. She singled in the third inning.
Okay.
Went as far as second base. One ball, no strike on Lawson. Lawson steps back into the batter's box. Here's the pitch by Murphy. That's low. It's about a foot in front of home plate. Two balls and no strikes on the Tigers' catcher. Sun going down. It's right down the third base line. It's a challenge to see at this point, but we'll keep you covered. Here's the pitch by Megan Murphy. Foul ball out of play down the right field side. Two balls and one strike on Madison Lawson. When the Kittens come back up in the top of the sixth, they'll be close to the top of their lineup, the 2, 3, and 4 batters.
Hi, Maddie.
That pitch low and inside. Friday night locker room scoreboard shows 3 balls and 1 strike. One out in the bottom of inning number 5. Cocoa Tigers down by 5 runs, 6-1 to the Ashland Kittens. Ball 4. Lawson takes a walk and reaches base for the second time tonight.
Now batting number 2, Abby Sullivan.
Now batting for the Tigers from Cocoa High School, shortstop number 2, Abby Sullivan. Sullivan struck out in the first. She got a sac fly RBI in the third inning, bringing home Cassidy Metzger for the one and only Cocoa Tiger run of this game tonight. First pitch called strike, no balls, and 1 strike. Murphy's pitch. Swing and a miss, quickly, no balls, and 2 strikes.
A
lot of events coming up on the Space Coast in the next few weeks. Saturday, April 30th, a huge event at Eastern Florida State College, a showing of Black Hawk Down the movie. A number of Army personnel, Rangers, that were there that day in 1993 will be attending. We'll stop the movie halfway through for a question and answer period. That's at Eastern Florida State College, 7 o'clock at night. On April 30th, Sullivan goes down on strikes. So now there's two outs in the bottom of the fifth. Colonel Danny McKnight will be there as well.
How about in number four, Corey Maxton?
From Task Force Ranger. So what an exciting... What an exciting and unique fundraiser it'll be. You stop the movie halfway through and you can ask the guys that were really that were there that day, say, hey, did this really happen? Caught by the third baseman off of the ball. Corey Mackman, a great play, a diving play by the third baseman. I'm not sure they had a position change. Sometimes they'll do that. No, they did not. Haley Kilburn moves to her left, lays out, records the third out here in the fifth inning. Ashland still up by a score of 6-1 over the Cocoa Tigers. No runs, no hits, no errors, and one runner left. After five complete, Ashland 6, Cocoa 1. But the fundraiser we have going on will be on April 30th. The Black Hawk Down movie showing will benefit the St. Baldrick's Foundation, which is the largest organization in the country that specifically is designed to raise money for pediatric cancer research. So we have a lot going on. We've got that. We've got three events coming up this Saturday. It's Rockley's night at Space Coast Stadium in early May. Seems like every weekend for about the next 6 weeks, there's something going on in and around the Space Coast. So it's an exciting time to live on the coast in East Central Florida.
Leading off for Ashland, number 14, Katie Baldick.
So we're set to move to the top of the sixth inning. Ashland 6, Cocoa 1. It'll be Katie Baldick, Megan Murphy, and Haley Kilburn. Line drive, base hit by Baldick. In the gap, going for second, and reaching second easily is number 14 with a stand-up double to lead off the top of the sixth inning. Baldick gets her first base hit of this contest. That'll bring up tonight's pitcher for the Kittens,
number
12,
Megan Murphy.
Murphy, a perfect 3-for-3 tonight, along with throwing an outstanding game. First pitch foul straight back out of play, no balls, and one strike on Megan Murphy. Murphy's had a big night. A number of players for the Ashland Kittens have played well tonight. Diana Robinson still in the circle for the Cocoa Tigers. That first next pitch is low. Evens it up at 1-1. Nobody out in the top of the sixth. The Kittens threatening to add to their 5-1 lead. Well hit ball to deep center field over the head of the center fielder. One run will easily score. Going for third, trying to stretch it. Now she's caught in the rundown. This is Murphy. Diving hit first, back into second. So credit Megan Murphy with an RBI double. Thought about stretching it to three, went about halfway. Tigers forced her back to second base. Katie Baldock easily scores from second base. Kittens on top, 7-1. As Maddie Green trots to second base, she'll run for the pitcher, Megan Murphy.
How about it, number 51, Haley Kilburn?
And that'll bring up the third baseman, number 51, Haley Kilburn, who made a great play to end the last half inning at third base. Kilburn 1-for-3 tonight. She singled in the first inning, struck out in the second, and grounded out to shortstop in the fourth inning. Pitch gets past the catcher, easily advancing to third base is Maddie Green. So now the Kittens with a runner on third base, up by 6. Quick timeout called by Mike Lawson, head coach of the Cocoa Tigers. He's going to visit his pitcher, in the circle, this time out, brought to you by Community Bank of the South. Three locations, one at 277 North Sykes Creek Parkway in Merritt Island, one on State Road 524 in Cocoa, and the other at 1902 South Fisk Boulevard in Rockledge. Community Bank of the South provides personal banking, online banking, business banking, commercial and residential loans, and other service. Community Bank of the South is an equal housing lender and FDIC insured. We'd also like to thank DeCandio & Associates Allstate Insurance. They have two locations, one in Port St. John at 950 Fay Boulevard, the other in Mims at 3239 North Highway US 1. For auto, home, life investments, disability, plus boats, motorcycles, four-wheelers, renter's insurance. Jennifer DeCandio, agency principal and associates, Allstate Insurance. Now we're about ready to resume play. Kilburn steps back into the box. That pitch is just a little low. Three balls and no strikes on the Kitten's third baseman. Maddie Green running at third. Ball four, Kilburn walks to first base. So she reaches base for the second time tonight.
Number nine, Sydney Campbell.
That'll put runners on the corners for the Ashland Kittens. And bring up the catcher, number nine, Sydney Campbell. Trying to pick off the runner at third, and they got her. Taking a couple steps too far off of the bag was Maddie Green. Nice throw by Madison Lawson to catch Green at third base. So now there's one out. Kilburn advances to second base. Campbell lines to one hopper to third. Makes the throw across the diamond to first. Nice play by Mackenzie Hoffman on a well-hit ball. But now, just like that, there's two quick outs. And that'll bring up first baseman number 32, Maddie Schivel. Maddie would like to give a shout-out to her friends and family in Ashland. Schivel one for three tonight. She ground out to shortstop in the first inning, swing and miss. She had a base hit and scored in the third inning, and she flew out to center field in the fourth inning. A one pitch by Robinson, just a little high, evens it up. It's 1-1. Two outs in the top of the sixth. Ashland 7, Cocoa 1. Once again, the Kittens will play Merritt Island tomorrow. Foul ball down the third base side. Well struck by Schivel, just a little bit foul. No, Ashland has played a couple of teams from Kentucky. They're down on spring break, playing in the Cocoa Beach area, courtesy of Space Coast Daily, who's going to put the tournament together. Line drive, base hit, one run will score. So credit Schivel with an RBI single. Kilburn easily scoring from third base.
Now batting number 21, Olivia McKenzie.
And that'll bring up the left fielder for the Ashland Kittens, number 21, Olivia McKenzie. McKenzie one for two tonight. She also reached on a bunt, so she's been on base twice tonight. Scored one time, called strike, no balls, and one strike on Olivia McKenzie. Pitch by Mayanna Robinson. No balls, two strikes quickly on McKenzie. Two outs, Tigers trying to record the third out and get out of this half of the inning. Ashland's already scored a couple of runs in this inning. They're up 8-1 over the Cocoa Tigers. That pitch high, allowing Maddie Schivel to easily advance to second base. Robinson held on to that one just a little bit too long. Ball went about 2 or 3 feet over the head of Madison Lawson. Pitched by Robinson. Oh, no. Okay, a couple feet back. Not sure whether to protect me or the equipment. I'm going to protect me first, and this nice lady next to me is going to protect me. I need all the help I can get. What is your name?
Donna.
Thank you, Donna. I have a lookout now. I have somebody. She's looking out. I don't know how much protection she's going to get. Oh, she's a nice lady. She's going to help. Donna's the lady with the camera.
I'm the paparazzi of Ashland.
You got what?
I'm the paparazzi of Ashland.
All right. Quick timeout call by Scott Ingram. He wanted to talk to his batter. McKenzie steps back into the batter's box. One ball and two strike count. Off-speed pitch, ground back to the pitcher. Nice play by Robinson. She flips it over to first base to record the third out in the top of the sixth inning. So for the Ashland Kittens in the top of the sixth, they come up with two runs on three hits, no errors, and one runner left. 8-1 Ashland. As we're just about set to move to the top, excuse me, the bottom of inning
six. Leading off for the Tigers in the bottom of the sixth, number 19, Mayanna Robinson.
Yes. It'll be Robinson, Murphy, and Miller for the Cocoa Tigers. Mayanna Robinson, pitcher versus pitcher. Here's the pitch. Low, one ball and no strikes. Alyssa Murphy on deck, Chelsea Miller in the hole. Megan Murphy still in the circle, pitch. Out of the zone, two balls and no strikes. Mayanna Robinson 0-1 today. She struck out in the first. She walked in the third inning. Quickly, Robinson in control, three balls and no strikes. Murphy steps out just a minute. Now she gets back on the rubber. Here's the 3-0 pitch. Inside, ball four. Mayanna Robinson will walk for the second time tonight.
Now batting number 44, senior Alyssa Murphy. Dust up.
Reagan Hughes now running for Mayanna Robinson. Alyssa Murphy set to step into the batter's box. Murphy 0-2 tonight. She struck out in the second inning. She ground back to the pitcher in the third inning. First pitch called strike. No balls in one strike. The speedy Reagan Hughes running at first base for Robinson. Pitch by Murphy, off-speed pitch in the dirt. Nice job blocking, but trying to advance second. And doing so is the courtesy runner, Reagan Hughes. It was a nice block by the catcher, Sydney Campbell. She went down to her knees, shifted to the right. The speed of Hughes, though, allowed her to reach second base rather easily. Foul, straight back, just got a piece of that one. one ball and two strikes on Alyssa Murphy. Tigers from Coco down by a score of 8-1. Ashland Kittens have been in control since the first inning. They scored one in the first, two in the second, and three in the third. That ball fouled out of play down the right field side. Count remains one ball and two strikes. One-two pitch coming up from Megan Murphy. Just by the righty, ground ball to shortstop, a two-hopper thrown across the diamond. 6-3 put out, advancing to third. The first speed is Reagan Hughes. So Murphy grounds out to the shortstop. Now the Tigers with a runner on third, one out.
Now batting number 26.
And that'll bring up number 26, Allie Clemens.
Allie Clemens.
Clemens hitting in place of Chelsea Miller. So this will be the first plate appearance of the night for Allie Clemens. She'll be hitting in the number 5 slot. Kayla Anderson on deck. Coco down by a score of 8-1. Megan Murphy takes a look towards the first base dugout. Now she's in the circle on the rubber. Here's the windup and the pitch by the righty. Popped up, catcher has a chance at it. Nice catch by Sydney Campbell, the catcher for the Ashland Kittens. The ball was popped up in foul territory, about 12 feet behind home plate, slightly to her right. Now there are two outs.
Now batting number 99.
In the bottom of the sixth. And that'll bring up tonight's designated player for the Coco Tigers. That's number 99, Kayla Anderson. Anderson's 1-for-2 tonight. She singled in the second inning. She struck out in the fourth inning, pitched by Murphy. Ground ball right back to Megan Murphy. Drops it, regroups, flips it to first base to retire the side. So for the Coco Tigers, in the bottom of the sixth, no runs and one hit, no errors and one runner left. After six complete innings of play, Ashland 8, Coco 1. Once again, we'd like to thank Custom Print Screen Printing, located at 1740 South Huntington Lane in Rockledge. They provide textile printing products for family reunions, church gatherings, civic organizations, sports team uniforms, and business shirts.
Just a jump to the left. And then a step to the right. With your hands on your hips.
As we're set to move to the top of the seventh inning, Ashland up by a score of 8-1. Savannah Pruitt has entered the ballgame for the Coco Tigers. She'll be playing second base. So it'll be Caitlin McKenzie, Megan Atkins, and Gabby Ingram hitting 1-2-3. Does look like we'll have a pinch hitter or ground ball back to the pitcher. 1-3 put out reported for the first out, and that'll bring up wearing number 22, Sarah Mullins. This will be Mullins' first at bat tonight. She'll be hitting in place of right fielder Megan Atkins.
Now batting number 22, Sarah Mullins.
Ingram will be on deck for the Kittens. Mullins will be hitting from the right side. Mianna Robinson in the circle. She's gone all the way pitching tonight for the Cocoa Tigers. First squad down by score 8-1 to the visiting Ashland Kittens from Ashland, Kentucky. First pitch inside, one ball and no strikes. Down ball, second base. Come over there, field it. Will be Megan Atkins. Atkins picks up a base hit. That'll get the Kittens back to the top of their lineup. Center fielder number two, Gabby Ingram. Ingram 3-for-4 tonight. First pitch out of the zone, one ball and no strikes. One out in the top of the seventh for the Ashland Kittens. They're currently enjoying an 8-1 lead over the Cocoa Tigers. Ingram steps out just a minute now. She gets back into the box. Pitch high. It's been all Ashland tonight against the Cocoa Tigers. Ingram started off the contest with a double and eventually scored. And the Kittens have been off and running ever since. That pop up to second baseman. It looks like Pruitt will feel that one, and she does. So Ingram is retired for the second time tonight. And that'll bring up the shortstop for the Ashland Kittens, number 14, Katie Baldock. Baldock 1-for-4 tonight. She doubled and eventually scored in the fifth inning. Line drive to center field, base hit, second hit of the night for Katie Baldock. So now Sarah Mullins will be standing at second, Katie Baldock on first base, and that'll bring up the pitcher for the Kittens, number 12, Megan Murphy. Pitched by Robinson, fouled out of play, directly back, no balls and one strike on the Kittens pitcher. Good crowd on hand tonight, both from the Cocoa Tigers and the visiting Ashland Kittens. In Kentucky, they brought a great crowd. Two balls and no strikes on Murphy.
Here we go, Murph.
Ground ball, base hit to left field. One run will score easily. Sarah Mullins slides safely into home plate with the ninth Kittens run of this contest. And that was the fifth hit of the night for Megan Murphy. She's been on fire both in the circle and in the batter's box. Maddie Green once again will run for Murphy. Green's going to be standing on first base. Katie Baldock on second base. Haley Kilburn half swings at the first pitch. Umpire says she went around, no balls and one strike on Kilburn. Kilburn 1-for-3 tonight. She had a single in the first. She struck out in the second, grounded out to shortstop in the fourth, and walked and eventually scored in the fifth inning. Ground ball, two hopper to shortstop. Field it cleanly. Scoring from second base would be Baldock. Throw to third. She is safe. Ball gets past the third baseman. But Green goes nowhere. So credit Kilburn with an RBI single. Or ball was well hit to the shortstop. Regardless, she reached first base. You got to give the error to the shortstop. You hate to do that. The ball was hit, so unable to field it. So baby. Runners on second and third. Now for the Kittens, they're up by a score of 10-1. As Sydney Campbell steps in, looks at the first pitch, no balls and one strike. Maddie Green on third. Haley Kilburn, base runner, on second, no balls and two strikes. Still two outs in the top of the seventh inning. Pitch by Robinson. Tried to get her to chase one out of the zone. She did not. One ball and two strikes on Sydney Campbell. Once again, Sydney would like to say hello to Grams and Pop Pop. I love you. Popped up to the third baseman to end the top of the seventh inning. So the Kittens come up with a couple of runs on three hits, one error, and two runners left. After 6.5 innings of play, Ashland 10, Coco 1.
That's my granddaughter.
Oh, which one?
Sydney, number 9.
Sydney, all right. Grandma Donna.
I'm Grammy.
Grammy Donna. Watching Sydney play.
Off for the Tigers at the bottom of the seventh, number 8, Mackenzie Hoffman.
Sitting on the box, stomping feet, stop clapping, got a real good feeling, something bad about to happen.
It'll be Mackenzie Hoffman, Cassidy Metzger, and Madison Lawson for the Coco Tigers in the bottom of the seventh inning. Megan Murphy still in the circle for the Ashland Kittens. Immediately after this contest, do not go away. We're going to be talking to the players from Ashland, Kentucky, as well as head coach Scott Ingram. So sit tight. Don't shut this thing down yet, even after the game is over. We will be presenting our Friday Night Locker Room Player of the Game plaque. Who will it be? A number of ladies that played well tonight will be making that presentation and also talking to each of the ladies from the Ashland Kittens. One ball, one strike to Mackenzie Hoffman, rather. Hoffman struck out in her only plate appearance tonight. She's 0-1. Pitch low, two balls and one strike. Murphy takes a look at her wristband with all the pitches. 2-1 pitch by Megan Murphy. Outside, three balls and one strike. Mackenzie Hoffman hitting from the right side, wearing number 8. Swings through that pitch. Now the count's run full, three balls and two strikes to Hoffman. Payoff pitch coming to number 8. Fouled out of play down the right field side over the fence in foul territory. Count remains full to Mackenzie Hoffman. Kittens have looked sharp tonight. They lost an earlier game out of the boot. Trying to even up the day's win-loss record. That pitch just a little inside, ball 4. Mackenzie Hoffman will lead off the bottom of the seventh.
Now batting number 13, with a walk. Senior Cassidy Metzger.
Oh,
That'll bring up center fielder number 13, Cassidy Metzger. Off-speed pitch high, one ball and no strikes. On the number 8 batter, senior Cassidy Metzger. Once again, tonight is senior night at Coco. Corey Maxner, Alyssa Murphy, Cassidy Metzger, and Shyla True are the seniors on the Coco Tigers squad. All low, two balls, and no strikes. Madison Lawson on deck for the Tigers. Coco down 10-1 to the Ashland Kittens. Nice pitch by Murphy. Two balls and one strike. Sun gone down. It's still a nice evening. Absolutely no wind now. There was quite a bit of wind as we started the game. Squaring the bunt in fair territory. Third baseman feels it. Nobody could throw through. The ball was placed perfectly. There was a bunt kind of between the pitcher's mound and the third base by the time third baseman picked it up. Metzger safely
at first base.
So the Tigers now have runners on first and second, nobody out. Bottom of the seventh inning, they're down by a score of 10-1. Timeout. Quick timeout call by Scott Ingram. He's going to go to the circle and talk to not only Megan Murphy, the pitcher, but also the infielders as well. When we resume play, Madison Lawson will step into the batter's box. Lawson is 1-for-1 tonight. She singled in the third inning. She walked in the fifth inning. Timeout's over. Scott Ingram said what he had to say. No changes made as Madison Lawson now is ready to step into the batter's box. 10-1 Kittens lead. Nobody out in the bottom of the seventh. Pitch high, one ball and no strikes to the Coco Tigers catcher, Madison Lawson.
Hit on the ball now, hit on the ball, let's go. Come
on, Mario. Pitch by Murphy.
Nice!
To right field. Coach is waving the runner home. There will not be a throw, but there will be a throw to third. Runner safe at third as Mackenzie Hawkins crosses home plate. With the second Coco Tiger run of the night. RBI to right field, RBI single by Madison Lawson. She advances to second on the throw to third. That'll bring up the Tigers shortstop number 2, Abby Sullivan. First pitch to Sullivan is low. Sullivan struck out a couple of times. She did have a sacrifice fly in the third inning, scoring Cassidy Metzger for the first of two Coco runs tonight. Just gets a piece of that one, evens it up at one ball and one strike. Corey Maxner on deck for the Tigers. Still nobody out in the bottom of the seventh inning. Tigers down by 8 runs, 10-2. To the Ashland Kittens. Throw down to third base, trying to catch Mackenzie Hoffman asleep. Excuse me, Cassidy Metzger sleeping. They did not. She gets back safely to third. Madison Lawson, your runner for the Tigers on second. Cassidy Metzger running on third. Here's the pitch by Murphy. Nice pitch on the corner. Evens it up at 2-2. Once again, immediately after the contest, we're going to go out onto the field and talk to the girls from Ashland, make our Friday night locker room player of the game presentation, and also visit with Scott Ingram, the head coach.
There you go.
And base hit to right field by Sullivan. Two runners will score. Three RBIs tonight for the Tigers shortstop, Abby Sullivan. Scoring easily, Cassidy Metzger and Madison Lawson.
Now batting number 4, senior Corey Maxson.
Now, You notice I'm having to pause whenever they crank up the music. It is loud tonight. Corey Maxner stepping into the batter's box for the Cocoa Tigers. She's hitting in the number two slot. Tigers down 10-4, pitched by Murphy. Foul ball down the third base side. No balls and one strike on Maxner. Corey Maxner 0-3 tonight. She ground back to the second baseman in the first inning. She struck out in the third inning, and she lined to the third baseman in the fifth inning. Number four waiting the pitch from Murphy. Low snap throw to first base. Sullivan gets back safely. Count is one ball and one strike on Corey Maxner, the Cocoa Tigers' first baseman. Mianna Robinson on deck for the Tigers. Foul straight back. Good hustle once again by Sydney Campbell. Really didn't have a shot at that one. The ball hit the screen about halfway up. So the ball falls to the ground. One ball and two strikes on Corey Maxner. I'm stepping back into the right side. 0-2 pitch. Set to come out of the hand of Megan Murphy, and here it is. Bang-bang double play. Nice job by the first baseman, Maddie Shivel, of the Ashland Kittens. So now the Kittens are one out away from winning this contest.
Now batting number 19, Mianna Robinson.
Travis enjoying the game tonight. Saying they're enjoying the game tonight. They're teamed up by a score of 10-4. They should be happy. The girls have played well as Mianna Robinson steps into the batter's box. One ball and no strike. No strikes, rather, on Robinson. Robinson 1-for-2 tonight. She did walk, so she's reached base a couple of times tonight. Nice pitch. Evens it up at 1-1. Once again, do not go away immediately after the broadcast. We'll be talking to the girls from Ashland, as well as head coach Scott Ingram, and making our player of the game presentation. Who will it be? A number of ladies have played well tonight for Ashland. And the challenge tonight to narrow it down, but that's what we do each and every broadcast. Two balls and one strike. Robinson, here's the pitch by Murphy. Just a little inside. Now the count has run to 3-1. Murphy one out away from walking away with a win tonight from the circle. 3-1 pitch by Megan Murphy. Is high and away. Ball four. Her counterpart, Mianna Robinson, will walk to first
number
base.
Number 44, senior Alyssa Murphy.
The best step.
My first
That'll bring up the left fielder for the Cocoa Tigers, number 44, Alyssa Murphy. Reagan Hughes, courtesy runner on first base for the Tigers. First pitch by Murphy is low. Hughes is going to walk to second base practically with her speed. So the Tigers now with a runner on second base. They're down 10-4 to the Ashland Kittens. Bottom of inning number 7, two outs. This is a regulation 7-inning game. So the Kittens are one out away from winning this softball game. Here's the pitch by Murphy. It's low as well. Two balls and no strikes. Allie Clemens on deck for the Cocoa Tigers. Here's by Murphy, ground ball, second baseman. Kittens have defeated the Cocoa Tigers by a score of 10-4. So we're going to change headsets, run out to the field, talk to the girls from Ashland. Do not go away. Okay, we're going to be off and running. Let's see what we got out here. We're going to grab the girls as they head back. Now, let's see how fast I can run out to the first base side to see if we can grab Coach Ingram before he has a chance to get his girls out in right field. That's the plan. Let's see if we can do that, because I want to do that before we get off the air. It's going to be a quick shout down. We're going to see if we can grab a quick word with Coach and the young ladies before you talk to him. Coach, congratulations. Big win tonight. Your thoughts?
Just had a good team effort offensively. Murph pitched a good game. Pretty solid defensively.
A team effort. Ken, we go around the horn and talk to the girls.
I prefer you talk to them. Yes, sir.
Okay, I've got about, because we have to go off the air in just a few minutes. Ladies, we're live. Congratulations, a big win. We wanted to go around the horn, get you to introduce yourself to a lot of people from Kentucky listening. If there's anybody you want to give a shout-out to, now is the time to do it. I want to give us your name, and if you want to say hello to anybody, fire away.
Michaela Akers. Maddie Shivel.
Caitlin Ferguson.
Abby Sambo.
Katie Ballock. I want to give a shout out to my fam back in Kentucky.
All right.
Maddie Green.
Olivia McKenzie.
Megan Atkins.
Megan Murphy.
Haley Kilburn. Just wanted to say I love my mom.
I love it. I love it.
Sarah Mullins. We love our fans.
Gabby Ingram. Hey, Papaw.
Zoe Ingram. Hey, Papaw and Mamaw.
Caitlin McKenzie.
Cindy Campbell, Mike, Cindy, what up?
All right. Hey, we're not done yet. We're going to hit the coaches.
Shane Campbell.
Don Murphy.
Don Murphy. Thanks for having us.
All right.
DJ Red Eye.
DJ Red Eye. Well, congratulations, ladies. A terrific win tonight. The name of our radio program is the Friday Night Locker Room. Every broadcast, we have a player of the game. It's a real challenge, especially when you play like you did tonight. There were so many young ladies that played well, but we've narrowed it down. It's normally one, but we're going to present two players of the game. And it's a challenge. First, we're going to talk to number two, Gabby Ingram. Gabby was 3 for 5, had a couple of RBIs. You're the leadoff batter. Your job is to get on base. Your thoughts on the game tonight?
I thought we did really well. Hit the ball well. I don't know.
Hey, I like the sound of that. Our other player of the game will be Megan Murphy. Where's Megan? All you did, Megan, was strike out 10 batters. You were 5 for 5 tonight. Terrific outing. Your thoughts?
Thank you.
A lady, a few words. I would like to make a presentation. I have a couple of plaques for both of you. Megan, that's yours. You are our Friday Night Locker Room Player of the Game. Gabby, for you as well. We hope you're enjoying your trip to Florida. You have one more game. You have another game tomorrow, I understand?
Thursday.
Your name, please, and how are you going to do in those games?
I guess.
Your name? And
Sydney Campbell, the best I can.
Sydney Campbell is going to play the best she can. Well, congratulations, a terrific outing. We enjoyed covering the game tonight. Enjoy the rest of your stay and be safe going home.
Thank you.
That is the Ashland Kittens from Ashland, Kentucky. A terrific outing by those young ladies. They did everything they needed to do tonight. They defeated the Cocoa Tigers by a score of 10-4. It was all Ashland. They scored one run in the first inning, two runs in the second inning, three runs in the third inning, so before the Tigers could blink an eye, they were down by a score of 6-0 to the Ashland Kittens. But obviously not a district contest for the Cocoa Tigers. District play begins next week for Cocoa. This was a game that the Tigers needed to prepare for next week, because you play all year long to put yourself in the proper position as far as seeding is concerned. The second season gets underway next week for the Cocoa Tigers. It will be district tournament time. The top two teams in each district will advance, so the Tigers will live to see another day even after today. So we're going to shut things down for the night. We hope you enjoyed tonight's broadcast. We'd once again like to thank our sponsors, Mike Urban Nissan Cadillac, Beef O'Brady's, Knutson Brain Spine Injury Law Office, Planet Fitness, Florida Master Temp, Al's Trophy Shop, Space Coast Tire, Community Bank of the South, Custom Prints, Barry Signs, Jimmy's Restaurants, and DeCandio and Associates. So, for Zach Clark back at the studio, I'm Steve Wilson. We hope you enjoy the broadcast tonight. Please, please be safe, and we will talk to you next time. Good night.